Hey guys, I'm back today down at my South Skagit property. We're gonna do some alder thinning, some more alder thinning. I've done some work in the past on this section over here. You can see it's opened up. I've got a lot more work to do down the road. The idea is to get the alder opened up enough to where I can underplant conifers, have the conifers come up. In about 20 years, the alder will be mature. I'll take the alder out and I'll have a conifer stand ready to go and replace them. Behind me, here's a section I did a couple years ago. I thinned this out to what I thought was a good trees per acre. I think it's a little bit too thick still. I did some underplanting in here a couple years ago. Let's go take a look at the trees and how they've been doing, but then I want to measure some of these alders I left and see what the spacing is, and then we can figure out the trees per acre. I really want to get it back to that 15 to 20 foot spacing, which is about 200 to 100 trees per acre of the alder, and that'll give me enough light, enough air to underplant in the conifers and let them grow up through as the alder mature. Here's a little Doug fir. It grew about 12 to 16 inches last year, and it's here under these two, one's an alder, one's a birch. So it's getting enough sun that it's growing pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that growth. We're right on the edge here where it's getting a lot of sun from this clearing. But I want to walk you guys back in here if I can. Now we're kind of in the thick patch of alder. Here's a little cedar that got browsed. It's in trouble there. Where's some of my other trees I planted here? Boy, they're really hard to find once it gets all overgrown. Here we go. Here's a little cedar that has not been browsed yet, but you can see he hasn't grown much. There's a grand around here somewhere, I think, if I remember correctly. There's another Doug. He's got about 12 inches on him, so he's grown fine. Here's a little grand. He's got maybe 6 inches right here, so he's not doing very well. He needs some more light. And let's get our rangefinder out. We'll figure out what kind of spacing we got in here. So I measured off this birch here. That tree right there is 8 feet away. That one's 12 feet away. That one's 10 feet away. That one's 10 feet away. That one's 15. That one's 15. So if I want 15 foot spacing, that one's 3. I should leave this tree and take out that one, that one, that one, that one, that one, that one, and leave that one way over there, leave that one over there, and take out all the ones around that one. So I left way too many trees in here. I'm at 400 or 500 trees per acre of the alder I left, and it's just, you're never gonna get anything to grow very well coming up through the understory. So I gotta get in here and take out quite a few of these trees I left. And the strategy when I was doing it was leave more, take less, but if you take them out down to 50 trees an acre, you can't put them back. So that was my strategy. I didn't open it up enough, so now I got to come back and clear out some more of these trees, which isn't a big deal. It's just, you know, gotta go back to work here. So here behind me, I just got done thinning out a little section. That's right about 15 to 20 foot spacing per tree. So you can see they're way spaced out. The tops aren't anywhere close to touching. I tried to leave the best tree candidates I could, but I got my stuff felled all over the road there. And now we've got enough light and air down onto the forest floor that I can put conifers all under here and they'll get enough light to come up through. Before, I missed it. I should have got a before and after, but before it looked like that, just dog hair thick alder. So I just got to work my way down the road there and clean all that out. So there's a before picture looking back down the road to the south. And there's a lot of wood that needs to come out of there. I've got my excavator. I piled up several decks of logs here that I'm going to skid back to the landing. I got a really fun project for all these here once they dry out next summer. So stay tuned for that. But I'm just gonna yank them all down to the landing, get them drying out. All right, guys, well, the sun's going down. It's about to get dark, so I got to stop for the day. So I thinned the stand out. I had to get the ones off the road. I still got quite a few in there in the woods. I got to get yarded out with the skidder later. But that's what it looks like. It really opened it up. Let's get up here, up the road a little ways to where I took that before shot. But you can see where now you're going to get a lot of sunlight down onto the forest floor. All these little pink flaggings, these stakes with pink flaggings. I've got trees that I planted a couple years ago. They've pretty much been stagnant. They really haven't done a whole lot. But I'm hoping when I get this all opened up, those things will really take off. So right about here somewhere, let me turn around. Right about in here is where I showed you the before shot. And I think I can get that overlaid on the screen, but we got a before, and then this is what it looks like afterwards. And I took a lot of little tiny guys out of here. Some of them are bigger sized, but I was going for that 15 to 20 foot spacing. And now you can see it looks pretty good. Let's walk in here. We'll take a little look at some of these trees I was telling you about. So a lot of the ones that will do good in here are cedar, because they're fairly shade tolerant. There's a little cedar. These got browse last year, so they're already stunted from the deer browse. Another little cedar here. I knocked my post over. I got to come through and cone these so they don't get browse. But that's a healthy looking cedar. That's a nice looking little cedar. And now hopefully, now that he's got some sunlight that's going to come down to him, he'll start growing. I've got a few dugs. They're really suffering. Dugs do not do well in the shade. These guys are pretty stunted. That guy only got about 3 or 4 inches of growth last year. Over here, there's a patch of spruce I want to show you. Little spruce seedlings that are doing pretty good. But like I said, I got a bunch of stuff hidden here on the floor that I got to get yarded out of here, trying not to hit my seedlings. That was a little cedar. Here's some of those spruce I was telling you about. So the spruce actually do pretty well in the shade, but they do well in the wet. And I've got wet, let me tell you. It's wet and clay here. But this one, even in the shade, it grew about a foot. And my hope is that next year it'll grow 2 or 3 feet. You can see down here, this is probably the first year's growth, about 2 inches, and then it grew 3 or 4 inches the year before, and then this last summer it got about a foot of growth going there. Well, it won't focus, there it goes. But I lost a lot in here. I had planted it really heavy, but I think a lot of them just got shaded out and browsed down. So I'm learning for sure, but let me tell you, this whole planting trees and getting a forestry growing is really, really difficult. It's a lot harder than I thought it was gonna be. And here's a little grand I just found. He's doing okay, 6 or 8 inches of growth. But even the grands, once they get established, they do really well in the shade also. So here's something I wanna show you. This is kind of the whole reason why I'm doing this. This is a alder I just cut. You can see the rings. It was growing really fast when it was young. And I've counted a lot of these rings. These trees were all about 22, 23, 24 years old. But it would grow really, really fast here at the beginning. And then after about 8 or 10 years, it had so much competition that it slowed way down. And see the rings get much closer. And so they're all competing for light and nutrients in the soil. And there's this one, there's that one, there's this one. There's one here, there's one here. And so it's just too thick. So it's just like your garden. You wouldn't plant all your tomato plants 2 inches apart and expect them to grow up and have a bunch of ripe tomatoes at the end of the season. You gotta get them space, you gotta get them water, nutrients, light, all that kind of stuff. And it's the same thing with these trees. They're 20 years old, they've been here a while, right? But they gotta have enough space to grow. And when they all grow up real tight and close, the whole forest gets choked off. So this is just a thinning project. It's just like weeding your garden. So we're gonna get all the alder opened up. They're gonna grow up big and strong and get tall and turn into real big trees. The conifer in the understory is gonna grow up. So when we take out the alder in 20, 30 years, the conifer will be there to replace them. And so it's just this whole cycle, and we gotta keep the forest healthy and going. And part of that is thinning and getting the tree spaced. So there's a little update about what's been going on down at my Skagit property. Hope you guys enjoyed it. We'll see you on the next video.